Previous video, I unboxed this rod right here. It's the FPA85. I'm going to do the first part of building this rod. So first off, we have to find the spline, which all you need to do is get a smooth surface and find the natural bend in the rod, which we already found it. This is a spot for the natural bend. I brought my dad along to help me mix the epoxy and put on the real, well, my grips. We put on the masking tape around the threads of the reel seat so the epoxy won't get into the threads, so it's hard to move the reel seat up and down. So what we're doing here is grabbing some epoxy, half and half, to the best ability so that we can put it on the spots that we need it so that we can finish out the rod for the first part. All that we need to do is just mix it around. So now that we mix the epoxy, all that we need to do is stick on our grip in our reel seat. Then our winding track. And now we have to put the epoxy on the rods until we can't move the grip any further. Now that we have spread the epoxy onto the rod, it's time to slide our reel seat or reel grip onto the rod.
Spin it as you go.
All you need to do is grab your 91% rubbing alcohol for cleaning up the excess epoxy. So now that we have wiped off the epoxy, it's time to put on the reel seat. All you need to do is add some epoxy to the rod crank. And now you just have to slide the reel seat down.
Remember to spin it.
It's time for the winding check. All you have to do is just slide the epoxy on. Now you just slide the winding check down to the reel seat. Now it's time to take the masking tape off after you wiped all the excess epoxy off. And there you go, you have your first part of the MHX rod done. Make sure you clean all the excess epoxy off. And we usually let it sit overnight, but you can let it sit 5 to 6 hours. Please make sure to subscribe, like, and please watch the next video where we put on the guides.